One of the powerful functions of these AI assistants and chatbots is the ability to take direct files from the user as the chatbots are conversing with them. So I'm going to run through really quickly how to set this up using two things, which is JotForm and VoiceFlow. So this is the JotForm dashboard, and you can sign up for a free account, and it lets you make up to, I think, 5 forms with some limited integrations and functionality, but it's enough for you to kind of get started and understand how that works. So we're going to create a form from scratch here. There's thousands of templates in here to kind of give you an idea of what you can do. If you have existing forms already, when I create e-sign stuff, you can kind of get wild here. For this basic example, we're just going to build a very quick form. We're going to use a tax assistant or an accountant as an example. You know, we got tax season coming up here. And let's say that we want to upload the user's W-2 tax form. We're going to just name this Humble's tax form here. And on the left-hand side, there's a plus button that says add form element. And I'm going to move myself over to the right so you can kind of get the full view here. If we scroll down, we see the one that we need for this example, which is file upload. So if I click, you're going to see the standard upload file here box. Name this, please upload your W-2 form. And that's it. That's all we need for this. So if we look up at the top, there's a build, a settings, and a publish column. So this was the build column that sets this up. If we go into the settings, it gives you a title here, enable, disable your form. Here's another nice thing about JotForm is the encryption capabilities, especially, you know, for some an example like tax, these W-2s are going to have PII and social security numbers and all that stuff. So you can really go down and set up passwords and all sorts of things to make this form usable. But what we want to do, so we want to go ahead and publish this thing. And if we preview the form here, you're going to see it's just a very, very straightforward form that says, hey, go ahead and upload this file. This link is what's important. And this is what we're going to incorporate into VoiceFlow using something called an iFrame. So I'm going to copy this link here. And we're going to head into our VoiceFlow example. This is a JotForm example. This is a very straightforward flow here, and I'm going to walk you through it quickly. So we just have a welcome message text that says, hello, I'm a tax assistant. And I always like to start, you know, with capturing their name to make it a little bit more personal and then acknowledge that. Nice to meet you. Tax time is around the corner. Let's get started with your personal tax return. Please upload your W-2 form below. This is where we set our iframe up. So the first thing we're going to do is set a new variable. And this is URL, which I have named here. And here is the link that we get from JotForm. So I'm going to come back to JotForm and make sure that I've copied this link. I'm going to replace it with the new form that we just created. And then you put this in double quotes here. Then we come to our iframe. So the iframe has a width and a height, which is going to be important to make it viewable in the standard VoiceFlow chat widget. And the other thing that you want to make sure and change is the title here, which is going to come up as we hover over the iframe, which I'll show you here. And then the source of this is the URL variable. And for those of you that want to just copy and paste this script directly into your chat, I'm going to show you where this is on the VoiceFlow Discord in a post that I made recently. So don't fret. But if we run through this test here, come back over here. Hello, I'm Umbral's tax assistant. I'm Connor. Nice to meet you. Tax time is around the corner. Let's get started. And you'll notice that there's just a gray blank here where the iframe should come up. And this is standard. The testing platform for VoiceFlow doesn't show this iframe, but it does show up on the front end. So if we go and look at an actual page where this chatbot is sitting, which is my website here with just the widget in the corner here. Hello, I'm Umbral's tax assistant. Who do I have the pleasure of speaking to today? Connor. Nice to meet you. Please get started. Okay. Oh, did we publish this thing? Form not found. Preform, where did I mess this up? Copy link. Let's make sure this is right. Oh, I know exactly what happened. I didn't hit publish. Okay. I need to hit publish on my chat. Let's restart this. Good old troubleshooting mid videos. Great. There we go. Okay, so my branding comes up. So with the free account from JotForm, you're going to get a lot of, you know, do you want to upgrade this, create your own JotForm and stuff like that? If you have a paid JotForm, you can get rid of all this, which will make the iframe look a little better in this chat window. Umbral's tax form, please upload your W-2 form. And here we go. If we click in here, and I'm just going to upload just my logo and hit submit. Thank you. Your submission has been received. Okay. And then if I come back to JotForm's dashboard here, I have this tax form here. And if I look at the inbox of this form, I'll see that this was uploaded into the JotForm dashboard. What's really nice about this, though, is if I head back to the form itself and hit edit, I can go to settings. On the left-hand side here, integrations. So you can directly tie the form submissions to whatever backend you're using, whether it's a Google Drive or your client CRM. That way, as soon as a user uploads a file, it can immediately be integrated and sent to whatever backend you need. But anyways, that's it. I hope that you found this useful. And for those of you that want that iframe script, follow the VoiceFlow Discord links that I'll put in the video below. Let me know what your thoughts are in the comments, and I hope you guys have a happy holidays. Thanks.